Hello, my name is McCray Mizgano, and I'm an applications engineer for Texas Instruments' current and position sensing product line. In this video, we will provide an introduction into hall-based position sensing systems that use a head-on configuration, which is a configuration where the system magnet moves in the same direction as the hall effect sensor's direction of sensitivity. We will provide examples of different applications that can use this configuration, the advantages of this contactless solution against mechanical solutions, as well as some of the criteria used to select a linear Hall effect sensor for these applications. Many systems have moving components that must have their linear position calculated. An example is the trigger in a power tool. A mechanism is often needed to translate the inputs from the user to a form that can be sensed and acted on by the electronics within the system. As an example, cordless power tools like power drills require a mechanism to translate the trigger displacement into a voltage that controls the speed of the tool. Traditionally, mechanical-based solutions, such as those using potentiometers, were used to measure linear position. On the right, you see an example of a potentiometer solution for translating the trigger displacement into an output voltage. In this solution, the component named RPOD is a potentiometer that changes its resistance based on the trigger displacement. This potentiometer is in series with R-fixed, which is the fixed resistor. RPOD and R-fixed form a voltage divider, with the pod output signal being the output of the voltage divider. As the trigger displacement changes, the resistance at RPOD changes, which would cause a similar change in the output voltage. Mechanical solutions for determining linear position have issues with wear and tear reducing system lifetime, which may be worsened if the system is consistently exposed to large vibrations. A robust contactless method for measuring linear position can be implemented using a magnet and a linear hall position sensor. In this approach, a magnet is placed on the moving component so that it moves along with it. The linear hall position sensor senses the resulting magnetic flux density from the magnet. In this video, we see an example trigger implementation that uses a magnet and a linear hall effect sensor. The magnet is attached to the trigger so that when the trigger is pressed, the magnet moves along with it. The linear hall sensor translates the sensed magnetic flux density from the magnet into an output voltage. When using one-dimensional out-of-plane sensors, the device is sensitive to the magnetic field component that is perpendicular to the die inside of the package. For surface mount out-of-plane sensors, the magnetic field component that is perpendicular to the PCB surface is sensed by the hall sensor, as shown on the left. For through-hole sensors like the TO92 package on the right, the magnetic field component that is perpendicular to the marked side of the package is sensed. If the through-hole sensor is positioned so that it is perfectly vertical and not bent, this hall sensor is sensitive to the magnetic field component that is parallel to the PCB. If out-of-plane sensors are used, two magnetic sensor orientations can be utilized. The first option is a head-on configuration, shown on the left. For the head-on configuration, the linear axis of measurement of the hall position sensor is along the path of travel, which results in a unique mapping of distance to magnetic flux density if the magnet is aligned with the sensing axis of the hall position sensor. In the example shown on the left, the magnet moves perpendicular to the PCB. A surface mount out-of-plane device is used to detect the field in the Z direction, which is the direction that the magnet moves. In the trigger demo previously shown, the magnet travels parallel to the PCB, so a through-hole TO92 device was used. The TO92 device detects the field in the Y direction, which is the same direction that the magnet moves. For both of these examples, the sensed magnetic flux density is only all positive or all negative, depending on which pole of the magnet is closest to the sensor. In addition to being able to be used in power tool triggers, the head-on configuration can also be used for level or pressure sensing in washers and dryers and object or wall detection in a robotic vacuum. As an alternative, a slide-by configuration can also be used by using a one-dimensional surface mount out-of-plane sensor, as shown on the right. In this example, The hall sensor senses the magnetic field component that is in the Z direction, but the magnet moves in the Y direction. The sensor is offset but not in the path of the travel. For this approach, the sensor sees both positive and negative fields if both the south and north poles of the magnet go past the sensor. Depending on the travel path of the sensor, however, please note that the slide-by displacement orientation may see the same magnetic flux densities at two different distances. As a result, for 1D sensors, the travel path should be restricted so that there is a one-to-one mapping between displacement distance and magnetic flux density seen at the sensor. Linear hall position sensors can have an analog output voltage, a digital PWM output, or a digital communication interface like SPI or I2C. An analog output voltage is common for one-dimensional linear hall position sensors and require an external ADC, which further adds to the error of the system. Digital communication interfaces are common for three-dimensional hall position sensors that have an internal ADC that digitizes the sensed magnetic flux density into an output code that is read from its interface. For PWM output devices, the duty cycle ratio of the output pulse varies based on the sensed magnetic flux density. A PWM output provides more immunity to external noise. The sensitivity of the hall sensor translates the magnetic flux density into the units of the associated output. The sensitivity is in units of millivolts per millitesla for analog hall sensors, percent duty cycle per millitesla for PWM linear hall sensors, and LSB or code per millitesla for linear hall sensors with digital communication interfaces. A linear hall position sensor should be selected so that its magnetic range is larger than the maximum magnetic flux density in the system, while also ensuring that the maximum resolution is obtained for better accuracy. As an example, suppose that a hall position sensor has sensitivity variance that will result in a magnetic range of 20 millitesla, 39 millitesla, 79 millitesla, and 158 millitesla. If the maximum magnetic flux density that has to be sensed by the system is 45 millitesla, select the sensitivity variant that corresponds to a 79 millitesla range. The 79 millitesla range enables sensing of the maximum magnetic flux density produced, which cannot be done by the 20 and 39 millitesla variants. In addition, the 79 millitesla variant has a better magnetic flux density resolution compared to the 158 millitesla range option. Bipolar hall position sensors detect both positive and negative fields, as shown in the picture on the top right. On the other hand, unipolar sensors detect either only positive or negative fields. In the example output waveform on the top left, a unipolar device that only responds to positive fields is used. Head-on displacement configurations have a magnetic flux density that is either entirely positive or entirely negative, depending on whether the south or north pole of the magnet is closest to the sensor. As a result, a unipolar hall position sensor can be used for head-on displacement configurations. Since unipolar sensors only sense one polarity, they may have more sensing resolution compared to the corresponding bipolar device. However, since bipolar devices work with both poles of a magnet, it allows the magnet to be placed without determining whether a pole of a magnet is the south or north pole. In addition to the output interface, the sensing bandwidth must also be considered to ensure that the hall sensor is able to sample the maximum frequency signal expected in the system. Different systems have different available supply voltages. If the available supply voltages of a system are all outside of the operating voltage range of the hall position sensor, an additional voltage regulator device is needed to generate a voltage rail for powering the hall sensor. The voltage rail for powering the sensor must support a load current that is larger than the operating supply current of the sensor. In the datasheet snippet above, the power supply must be able to take a 10 milliamp current load and have a voltage either between 3 to 3.6 volts or 4.5 to 5.5 volts. To reduce average current consumption, power to the linear hall sensor can be removed when it is not needed by using an external load switch. Ratiometric devices scale the sensitivity linearly with the power supply voltage. For linear output hall position sensors, a ratiometric architecture minimizes error from VCC tolerance when the external ADC uses the same VCC for its reference. Please note that ratiometric devices may not scale the quiescent voltage, which is the opposite voltage when no magnetic field is detected. As a result, a ratiometric architecture may not completely reduce the error due to VCC tolerance. However, in these cases, it can still reduce the error, especially when the output voltage is relatively large compared to the quiescent voltage. If a ratiometric device is used and a well-regulated internal reference is used instead of VCC for the ADC reference, a variation of ADC output codes will be observed due to linear Hall sensor output voltage varying, but the internal reference staying fixed. The various sources of error are also used for determining which Hall sensors to select. Some of these error sources include output of heard noise, offset error, offset drift, sensitivity error, sensitivity drift, and sensitivity linearity, all of which are covered in details in other videos. If you would like to learn more about our Hall effects sensor portfolio, please visit ti.com/hall effect to explore our technical resources and products.